Hello viewer, welcome to Artistry. My name is Tirus Wanyoike. So we're in the process of making a project. We saw last time on how to prepare the cutting list. And from the preparation of the cutting list, we determined the length of timber that we need for the construction of a project of a stool. Now, before me here, I have the pieces which I have prepared now according to our cutting list. So the stand for the stool was this height, and then it has the 35 millimeter by 35 millimeter width and thickness. So it is square in cross section. In construction, we refer more of these materials at the cross section level. So the cross section of the stool is square. So we have the top. The top we agreed we're going to have 300 by 300, but I've come with this piece here now illustrating the process of lamination. We said these pieces are strips which are about this size. There are many of them, and then they are laminated, they are glued and pressed with a clamp, then they are trimmed. So this piece, I came with it without trimming so that it can illustrate the width, one of the width of the strips. And then many of them, we have clamped them, we have laminated, and then after trimming, we come up now with such a piece. This piece is now 300 by 300. So the thickness here is 20 millimeters. Then we have a square piece, 300 by 300. So the construction process. Now, we have a number of power tools that we use, and key among them, very important, is this machine. Some of the functions that we are going to do are done using this machine. So we call it the router machine. The router machine is used for so many purposes, and it has a lot of adjustments. The router machine is used to make molds, to make bevels, to round these edges, to round edges, and then to make the mortise hole. You can as well use it to make the tenon. Tenon is this part that could be used entirely to make this tool. But for us, I want us to combine a number of activities that could be used by the router machine. So the very important step that the router machine will do is to make the mortise hole. The mortise hole is this one that we see here, and then the rails will fit into that mortise hole. So the steps and the procedures of making the mortise hole, we have the router has a bit here that you can see right from there. The cross section is very important. It has four cutters. So the four cutters, this is a straight bit. We call it a straight bit because it is straight in nature. We have other bits that are curved or have the shape that to make a curve on the piece. So what happens, the router machine will perform any function that will fit the bit to suit. So for now, I have fitted the straight bit. It is straight in nature, and then it will be used to cut this hole. So what we do, we'll clamp it, we'll clamp the piece. Then we'll use the router. The router has a fence. This is a fence to the router. It will be fitted here. And so, and I now come to cut. Using the router machine, I'll adjust the machine up to where I want my hole, and then after putting it on, I will move the router forward and backward until I achieve that hole, because it will rotate and then to continue cutting as it goes down. Then we have the depth gauge. It will give me the gauge that I need depth wise, and then my hole will be made. So that is the router, and we can use it for so many purposes. Now after I'm through with this one, I'll unclamp and then clamp it this way, and then make this other hole, and then I'll make all the holes using the router machine and its fence used for guiding the router so that I don't get the holes off the marks that I have. So after that, then I'll have my stands ready. The rails will be made from the raw piece. The raw piece will look like this, a long piece roughly cut on the machine, the table saw, and then to be cut into various lengths according to the cutting list. We'll cut it into various lengths, and then to be cut again the beveling here will be done using the bevel square. The bevel square will be used to determine the bevel. So that bevel, I'll have to trace it from the paper. I determine the bevel and then adjust it like that. Then I tighten the wing screw, and then I'll use it to mark the other side, and then mark the other side as well. Mark the other side as well, all from the top part, and then I'll use the saw to cut and then chisel out. I'll use the chisel to chisel out, and then I'll mark the joint, because I'm cutting for A. This one I'll have to fit it A to A, and then I'll fit it, and then so you can see how well the joint will fit. So this is one of the joints that you see in the stool. It is quite a process making the joint. We mark A so that we can fit the joint exactly where it is supposed to be. And then I'll mark for B, and then get the stand for B, and then get it in. Get it in, and so that makes one side of my stool. So one side of my stool is already made. We have joint AA, we have joint BB, and then we still have an allowance for the other part of the stool that will move sideways. So I'll make another one exactly like this, and since I had marked, I just consider the rail for this part, J, then I have J and J, and then to just fit smoothly, and then the other side is K is right here. I'll fit it here. K. Now I have two of these, which should be exactly similar. So I have that part, and I have this other part. So in our construction process now, we measure for the rail that will run here. Then it should be fitted to complete our stool. So the process is as simple as that, though when you're making the holes, you have to be very precise so that you can use the appropriate tool to file, to chisel, to cut, and then you fit it in. After fitting it in now, we will finally see now the part that has been joined, and it will make the frame so that we can now put the top. So for now, we'll take a short break, and then we'll be back to see the part two of the joinery of the stool. So stay tuned.